Right, welcome everybody here in Twitch chats and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on over there for some Esper Hero. So this is a donation deck that we're going to be playing, as you can see up here. Oh wait, I got to use my cursor over here. There we go. Up here on the channel. That's what the DD always stands for, is a donation deck. This one is built around Hero of Precinct 1. Now this is a pretty popular deck from last format, especially towards the beginning of last format. It kind of tailed off. But we got some new additions here with War of the Spark, as you can see. I'm excited to play Sorin in this deck, because Sorin can minus and bring back Thief of Sanity or Hero of Precinct 1, which are like the two like maybe most important creatures in the deck. And you can use Sorin to bring them back right away. Or if you are able to go wide with Hero and you have a bunch of 1-1 tokens, there's times that those 1-1 tokens just aren't very impactful and just don't do enough. But maybe with Sorin giving them lifelink, that could really help also. So like that's a pretty good card, I think, to have in this deck. We also get Dobin's Veto, which is just an upgrade on Negate. And this is just awesome for the deck, because not only is it an upgrade on Negate, it also triggers Hero Precinct 1 because it's multicolored. So that's just a great card. I'm not as sold on Tyrant Scorn. We'll kind of see how it works. You know, just kind of looking at this card, I feel like there's better removal spells like Cast Down and stuff like that. This one is, of course, multicolored, but we'll see how it works. If our opponent's playing a lot of things that don't cost three or less, that cost more than that, then we get to replace it with Dispark in the sideboard. So that's kind of a cool combination, having like the Tyrant Scorn and Dispark. You know, you can play whichever one works against other decks. At the very least, against decks like at the very least, Tyrant Scorn's not dead against decks without creatures like Cast Down is. You can return your own creature back to your hand to save it from a removal spell or from like a sweeper or something like that. Besides that, we also got new card with Time Wipe. Same kind of thing. We get a sweeper that can also save one of our creatures. Liliana is an interesting choice in here. Liliana is not multicolored. It's like our only thing that's not multicolored, but it's just so powerful. I'm interested to see if Liliana is actually going to be worth it over playing another Teferi and something else, as like, you know, it's six mana, is so much mana. We'll kind of see if we get there and everything. You know, we're playing 25 lands in here. The one new card that kind of surprised is not in this deck is the new Teferi, the new three mana Teferi. I feel like that could fit really well, if not in the main deck, in the sideboard, Teferi Time Raveler, to, you know, just fight against control decks, not let them counter stuff. It's just great against, you know, it's just perfect against Wilderness Reclamation. So surprised that's not at least in the sideboard, if not in the main deck. That's the one card that I kind of wish we were playing. I have tried Narset in a lot of stuff. I actually thought that Narset was going to be really good as a sideboard card, and I've been a little disappointed. It has not been as good as I thought it would be. But there we go. So that's our deck. So let's try it. We have lots of new cards to kind of try, and we'll kind of see how it goes for us.
Hey, Hawkeye.
I'm thinking we're going to regret not having three mana Teferi in here. But I want to play the deck like it was donated for. Oh yeah, Oath of Kaya could be a good one against aggro if we needed to. Man, there's a lot of good choices to play. Yeah, Belhaunt. Bleh. Belhaunt's really strong. I like Belhaunt more than Elite Guard Mage. All right, good hand. We'll keep this one. Elite Guard Mage, of course, is easier to cast, but that fourth toughness is critical against the aggro decks, like where you want it. Oh man, there's so many decks to play. Double Teferi. So they just have Isolated Chapel right now. I'm going to take one Teferi. The next turn, Thought Erasure, the other Teferi. I could, you know, go with taking the cast down and, you know, hoping to draw a land for the Thief of Sanity. But if we don't draw the land, which we did not, I don't know. Cast Down is just a one for one spell. These Teferis just can win games. I want to take Teferis because I don't like them winning games. Yeah, Rexy, I'm usually on from 3 to 10. I'm getting on early today because I just wanted to play a lot of rank matches today with those four decks that we've played previously that we had a lot of success with. That's what I felt like playing today. But I have a lot of donation decks to do. And so got on a little early today to knock out one donation deck. Here first. So they obviously don't want to use the cast down on the hero. Hey, Top Hat, good evening. Or good morning, I guess. I'm doing really good today, yeah. Tessa, new Vivian, she's so cool. Yeah, new Vivian's awesome. Yeah,
I am not going to sit this
a lot of fun playing new Vivian.
You know what? I'm not done yet.
Ooh. Yeah, 3-mana Teferi would certainly help us in this matchup. But we're getting these Dovin's Vetoes, the Disparks, Duresses, Tyrant Scorn out, Detention out, Time Wipe out. Reborn in, Taker out. Do I want the other Contempts over the Takers? I guess so. Contempts in, Takers out. Our opponent did not have blue mana that game. Hey, Johnny Popeye. Yeah, when our opponent doesn't cast a single spell, our deck works pretty well. I could see playing Hostage Taker instead of Bell Haunt. I'm gonna play the Bell Haunts though. Basically, against specifically Thief of Sanity, I'd rather have Hostage Taker, but against them not having Thief of Sanity, I like Bell Haunt. So it's kind of tough. Hey, what's up, Scary Harry? JRC? Howdy, y'all. What's up, Gatsby? Hey, everybody. And yeah, iPad MTG, JRC right underneath you sent you that decklist command there with all the decks. Well, that definitely worked out really well for our opponent. Kept the Mortify in case of, like, how they kept their card quickly. I thought it could have been a Thief or a Search for Iskanta. But I guess it was a Dovin's Veto. Hey, Matthew. Playing Mardu midrange. Ooh. How's that going?
I am the master here. Putrid, all right. But
Liliana. Effective. That art is awesome. That Liliana Dreadhorde general art. It's pretty incredible.
Good help is easy to find in war.
Our opponent's 3-for-1 or 3-for-0 to us. We've had three cards that have just done nothing. Two Thought Ragers and a Duress. Good thing we have this Liliana. And we overcame 3-for-0-ing ourselves with one Dreadhorde General. Okay. Experience with Sultai so far? Like, are you talking about like with this deck against Sultai, or playing Sultai decks? If you're talking about with this deck against Sultai, that was our first match that we played. As you can tell there. And I guess if you're talking about playing Sultai decks, we played a Sultai flash deck with the new Vivian a few days ago, and it was really sweet. This is not good. Not good at all. One lander. Merfolk. Hey, Eisenath. Ow. Hero Precinct 1 was a great draw. That can really help us out. I guess I need a Deputy of Detention, the Deep Root Waters. Ah, I don't have to. Have not tried any feather decks yet, no. That is one of our donation decks to play as a feather deck. If anybody has a particular feather deck that they have really been enjoying. Let me know. I cast the Thought Erasure now because it's going to turn into a dead card in not so long. Well, those are two annoying things. Standout card so far. That's unfortunate. Okay, yeah, let's tap all five to put counters on. There's kind of too many standout cards to name. The set is really good. I don't think that there's like, and it's just, it's really even. There's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of good cards that are all, you know, good cards. Like, it's not a set where there's, you know, like a Teferi that's just a lot better than other things. That's good, Borderland Ranger. You'll have to let me know how it goes and everything. And yeah, I definitely agree with that, DJ Kittner. DJ Kittner says the set is awesome, and the only card in the last couple sets, the last three sets, that was a true mistake was Wilderness Reclamation. I agree with that as well. Thanks, Angry Dragon. Somebody sent me one yesterday, and so, you know, it's only one. Somebody sent me a code yesterday. There's only one. I can only use one code per account, so. I do not need a code, but maybe somebody here in chat could use one. That was a beating. We have a decent amount of stuff. I'm going to take out the Dovin's Veto and the two Teferis. And I'm going to put in another Bell Hunt. So, I mean, Kaya's good at, like, they don't have very many one drops, but they do have a couple. You know, like, they have that unblockable one that killed us that Kaya would be able to get. I guess I don't really want Thief of Sanity too much. Yeah, Thief's actually just really slow. So if we take out Thieves... Maybe I'm playing two Thief? I don't think I really want Duress or Contempt. Maybe Contempt. I don't know, we have a lot of 4-mana stuff. Maybe I just play the two Teferis. Alright, I'll play the two Teferis instead of the Thieves. Pickle Slick, what's up? Thank you so much for the Twitch Prime sub there. First sub of the day. Oh, I have today's sub goal at 10? Whoops. It's supposed to be at 0. Well, we'll just delete the 0, and now we're at 1. Alright, keep this. Oketra plus Vivian's Arcbow. That does sound pretty ridiculous. Oketra just on her own seems pretty ridiculous too, though. Alright, they still chose Merfolk. Bold. Oh, is Oketra just cast? Well then, yeah, I guess that doesn't really work then. Skydiver is pretty sweet. So far for this game, we've cast two Thought Erasures, and they have immediately drawn the exact same card that we got rid of both times. So I should start picking the worst card in their hand so they can just draw another one of those. So I can beat the system. That's what we gotta start doing. What's the worst card? Take that one. Mm-hmm. Time wipes kind of look cool in this deck. I would have cast Time Wipe this turn to get rid of that Kumana and everything if we would have drawn a Time Wipe. Or like if we would have drawn a land, sorry. Yeah, if we would have drawn a land. Yep, sure can, Valor Axial. I was planning on playing it tomorrow on stream. If that sounds good. I'm just playing the other Grixis deck today. And so I don't really want to play two Grixis decks on the same day, but then I'll play it tomorrow. So as long as that looks kind of good, then I will be, yeah, I'll be playing it tomorrow. All right, really want to draw land. Come on, land. All right, not a land, but so we can either get rid of the Kumena or the two Miscloaked Heralds. I think it's probably better to get rid of the Kumena, because the Kumena can just sit back and draw cards. They're both four unblockable. I like that trade. Alright, now they only have two unblockable. I like that trade. Okay. New toys for Sultai. Probably. There we go, drew that thing. They have a lot of options. The first thing that just came to my mind was the 3-mana Vivian. Really like that card. That was the first thing that popped to my mind as a new card for Sultai. Midrange. So we finally drew our fifth land. That should end the game. Kill a bunch of stuff. You think the opponent just left the game? I mean, they're up a game. That's only game two. Okay, yeah, free to play, really conservative with crafting new stuff, and you have a Sultai list right now. I would recommend just continuing to play your Sultai list that you have and just see if there's anything that you know need or anything. I just kind of wait, and you know, a lot of things are in flux, and but I mean, I think the 3-mana Vivian's good for the sideboard, if it's not in the main deck. But yeah, if you say you have a good Sultai list you like, just kind of keep going with it.
This isn't your average zombie horde. What a good mindless minion.
This isn't your average zombie horde. They're different levels of zombie hordes.
Rise.
Also, awesome, MD.
Love a good death wail. I'll find it useful. I've learned much from your death.
Hey players, welcome from Russia. Thank you. Yeah, New Lily's really strong. You know, she does cost 6 mana though, and you know, she came down after we'd already won the game basically. But she is really strong. It's just can we get her out there fast enough? That time wipe was really sweet. Time wipe with Deputy of Detention. That's a nice combo. That's a nice combo. You have Deputy of Detention for like the early defense. You know, forces the opponent to play a bunch more stuff, and then you get to pick up your Deputy of Detention, wipe out the battlefield, and still have that for something else that's after that. That's a nice combo. Watery Grave. You don't think this Lily fits in Sultai at all? I think if you're still playing Carnage Tyrant, is a new Lily better than Carnage Tyrant? Ooh, that's a lot of Mistbinders. I'm just going to take the Mistcloak Herald to make it difficult for them to double spell. You know, like otherwise they would like be able to double spell here and get like basically a 1-mana 2/2. I guess we have seen Curious Obsession. This is also pretty nice. Get to gain 3 life, have them discard a card. We can still time wipe, pick it back up. I like it. Time wipe's been sweet. I was basically saving a little bit of life there by mortifying that creature. I was saving 3 life instead of mortifying the enchantment.
My army was smelly, but effective.
Smelly, but effective.
Rise and shine.
Dang. Then they drew 3 lands in a row.
Ooh, this looks like a fun new toy.
Yeah, we may see a viable Super Friends list.
Of utter loss and despair.
This definitely had to minus 9, see what the animation was like. We hadn't, you know. Hadn't minus 9'd. Alright, we're 2-0. Esper Hero is looking pretty sweet. Got a pack. We'll crack those open later when we get to our sub goals. No, you do not need to have a creature for time wipe. No, you can still cast it without a creature. Okay. Ah, another one lander. Cool. We'll keep the 2. MTG bot being slow. We're gonna need that one. So we need one more white source for this bell hunt. But we got everything else in our hand unlocked right now. Hero Precinct 1 is usually a card with a bullseye on its head, which is really good for Thief of Sanity. Because you play your hero, and they're like, oh, I gotta kill that hero. And so then they use their removal spell on hero, and then you're like, ha, I got a thief. And then hope that they don't have another removal spell for your second lightning rod. Oh, but gates, though. Gates can just have gates ablaze. Well, I'm just hoping they don't have gates ablaze right away, basically, and hoping we get some hits in with Thief. Alright, not a gates ablaze. That's good. Whew. I'll take that one. I don't think we need to play the Bell Hunt. Because Bell Hunt still, like, they play a gate, gates ablaze that kills the Bell Hunt also. We'll wait. The Dargon God. So they have Guild Summit. Keep and Mortify available. They're probably thinking, like, what did I take over Vraska Relic Seeker? It's probably a short list. Yeah, Decklist is a little bit above you. If you just joined in, exclamation point deck. Did not draw the land. Took that Vivian. Yeah, looks like we got, you know, four color gate walkers. That's the wrong list. Surprised nobody else said that. All right, I'll get the correct list. There you go. That should be the correct one. So if they play Vraska minus on the hero, we get to just kill the Vraska with the 1-1. So I'm kind of expecting them to play the Gatebreaker Ram, and in that case we'll... Okay, never mind. So that's good. We just kill that with a 1-1, and then we get to actually tick up on Bolas. And do not want to... Yeah, I want to finish that off first before playing Bolas and ticking up.
Once again, my
revenge to make them get rid of something. Did they just get rid of Teferi?
A mote of wow. Power.
I am. Like, I think if I'm them, I'm getting rid of Angrath here. Because Teferi would be able to tuck the Nicol Bolas and put it back onto their library if they draw, you know, if they just drew the white source. Ah, they had another Teferi. That makes sense then. Since they have another Teferi, I'm going to go Bellhaunt instead of Thief. Or, well, since they have the Gates Ablaze. I don't really want to take the Gates Ablaze. I want to get the Teferi out of there so they don't get to get rid of my Bolas. Yeah, DD stands for a donation deck. Good job, HXC. Way to go.
I have other plans. My schemes are never ending.
Wild, you can't stop nature.
We got Bolas with Thief earlier. We had another Thief that hit him twice, that we got these two cards. Yeah, I sure do, Stork. Yeah, I think Grixis can be good enough to be a tier 2 deck.
feel the...
Ah, not again.
My schemes have been foiled.
Okay, cool, Matthew. I didn't know it was your birthday on Tuesday, and happy birthday. Happy early birthday, of course. I don't know why I didn't play Teferi there. Definitely, well, I don't know. So I think Tuesday stream, I'm planning on doing the noon to 7 stream on Tuesday, doing an early stream instead of 3 to 10. So, and then I'll go, so I can go watch the new Avengers movie with the half price movies on Tuesdays. All right, looks like we got a good amount of cards that are pretty good here. And Tyrant Scorn even just destroying, like, you know, the Gatebreaker Ram is an important one to kill. I don't like Deputy. That'll just get mixed up. And I don't really even like Hostage Shaker either. Deputy will just get mixed up in a Gates Ablaze. Yeah, we'll keep the Scorn. That can save our thief from a Gates Ablaze or just kill a Gatebreaker Ram. I like that. Ooh, all these Dovin's Vetoes. Why am I not playing Dovin's Vetoes? Yeah, I should play those. Ooh. No, I have not, Rex. I would assume that the new movie release is included in that, but I have not checked. Think we should cut Lily. I do kind of want these Duresses in there too. Duress is just awesome in this one. I could cut one Lily, one Sorin. For two Duresses. Yeah, Sorin is just a Planeswalker that gets back. You know, you get to minus it and you get your Thief of Sanity or Hero Precinct 1 back immediately. So it's, you know, it's just a 4 mana Thief or Hero plus sticks around to, you know, you can tick up and kill a Nicol Bolas or a Teferi. If they play either of those in minus immediately, you can play your Sorin and tick up and ping them. Bleh. These hands. Well, that was a fun game of Magic. Can't really imagine we're going to be winning this. That's some pretty sweet art, though, with that Gateway Plaza. And that shows, like the planar bridge entering onto Ravnica or something like that. Or some gateway, temporal gateway thing. Something like that. I was going to be mortifying this turn if we drew the land. They're too far ahead now.
You prepare the gallows. We've got company.
All right, let's try again. We'll try not to mold a five and not have lands to play stuff. We'll try to keep seven and curve out. We have more counter spells in the sideboard. There's just one in the main deck because it's a versatile card that, you know, it's good. It's nice to have a counter spell main deck against any kind of control deck or just spell heavy deck, but it's not something that you want a lot of because there are also like creature decks, and so just have one that if you draw it, it can be a nice bullet for you. What are these hands? Exact same thing as last time. Last time we just had three isolated chapels. In our opener, this time we have two Glacial Fortress. What is this? Back down to five. All right, never mind, we're at four. Well, that was our only card that mattered. I guess my favorite deck so far has probably been the Gruul Midrange that we're going to be playing last tonight. If I had to pick a favorite deck. Two and one. That was not a fun two games. Yeah, the same deck from Thursday. Yeah. I've made one change to it so far of taking out the Vivian's Arc Bow for another Vivian Champion of the Wilds in the sideboard. That's the only change I've made to it so far from Thursday. Well, I'm certainly not going to mulligan four lands, three spells after the last two games. Yeah, Eldest Reborn was really strong. That's a really good uncommon. What you got over there? Nothing? Something. Well, one of the two Rals down. Maybe we can deputy the other Ral and have it not go away. I mean, all they need to do is double cast a shock, though. No lands over there.
My experiments are mostly successful, except for that one.
We can get rid of a planeswalker. This was Teferi.
Mistakes were made, lesson learned.
A couple 1/3s staring at each other.
If I could just distill lightning into a potion, it'd never sell.
There we go.
I know my responsibility.
Get that out of here.
Time is much more malleable than people think.
All right, now I should have time to play the Liliana.
Ooh, a battle. I'm all tingly. Oh, for raw power, hurricanes beat dragons, no question.
I don't think we're beating three Rals.
I suppose that's how it was meant to happen.
Oh, I guess we're dead.
I do hope you make this battle exciting for me. Good.
I don't really need a deputy.
Find in war.
They have another one, so all they need is.
You are not.
They probably just need a land at this point. Hey, thanks for the host, Mogwai. Welcome everybody over here.
We are starting
with an Esper Hero donation deck, if you're just joining. And then after that, we're going to take the four brews that we made earlier in the week.
Now.
That we were
Do not ruin my
enjoying.
Dress. How disappointing.
And we're going to be playing some ranked with them after this. Vivian's Arcbow costs green mana, and this is an Esper deck. So it's kind of hard to have. That kind of hard to have those two together. All right, we got quads. Don't think our opponent's gonna have quad mortifies.
Well, that was unpleasant.
So don't think they probably don't have that beat. All good, J-Tom.
It's easy. Quantum particles, blah blah blah, and then you die.
So our opponent needed one more mana for to be able to combo us. It did seem like they used way too many resources to kill that Liliana, or make that Liliana matter more than it did. Hooray! You have something to mortify! Counter it. Counter it. Counter it. Hooray! We got more of them. Yeah, last few days I've been playing against a lot of Grixis. It's been a very popular deck. Hey, Doomwaffle, Magic Stream is pretty good. We just played a match last round where we didn't get to... we won game one, and then games two and three, we mulled to five, mulled to four, and didn't get to play Magic, and that was sad. And I thought we were losing this one, and so I was still sad, but now we're suddenly doing okay. So we're going to mortify this Augur Bolas, try to keep it a two-turn clock with 5 power on the battlefield, them being at 10.
That didn't pan out.
Teferi has been stricken.
That didn't go according to plan.
Pretty sure we were supposed to lose this game. I think they had the tools to... kill us. Looks like we're winning it now, though.
Beat me? Just try it. There's a storm coming your way.
Rael has 2 loyalty. Sounds good. So Hostage Taker is our only creature here. I think I actually just attack Rael and just get Rael off the battlefield for good instead of just playing Deputy of Detention. Wait, never mind, I have lethal. Alright, never mind, we have lethal. Sorry.
Taste my blade.
Yeah, that was... yeah. Sorry, my bad. The lethal. Yeah, that lag happened there. I realized that in the later games like that, whenever it's later... Yeah. Yeah, just refresh. Like, lag's gone now. How I looked at the graveyard and I scrolled back and forth on the graveyard, if I do that in a later game, it'll just really lag really bad. So that was... I should not have done that. That was my bad. I'm not sure what they may have side Brad as like additional threat besides just comboing. We'll see. Ah, Niv-Mizzet. Yeah, Niv-Mizzet could be one. Yeah, that could be one right there. Yeah, I could see that. All right, 2-1, and we are up a game. Thanks, Acrylics, saying this is my favorite arena stream. Everybody else plays the same deck over and over, and you actually play anything and everything. Thanks, yeah, that's what I like to do. I think I'd have a little bit more success with playing the same deck over and over, because you know, you could get to really fine-tune it and everything, but try to have different decks that, you know, other people will like. You know, some people like some decks, other people like others. All right, no Rouse. Kind of want to take the Chemist's Insight. Yeah, I'm going to take Chemist's Insight. I want to keep their resources low. And going to start casting these Bell Haunts, make them discard stuff. And yeah, sure, they can Lava Coil Bell Haunt, but takes another card out of their deck. Thanks, Sloth. Yeah, I don't have much on the screen overlay. You know, just have like some important details. Got my sponsors over here. I do 12-hour streams whenever we hit. Phoenix. That is a sideboard card I was not prepared for. Whenever we hit different goals of people going through my sponsor referral links and making some purchases. Rekindling Phoenix, huh? What are we gonna do about that Red Owl? Hey, good job. You opened 2 Sorens in your pre-release? That's awesome. I have 2 Contempts in here. A Contempt can take out a Phoenix. Oh, right. Good call. I should have just played Soren main phase. I usually, you know, I'm just kind of in the habit of going to attacks first, see if they, like, tap out to play any kind of removal or whatever, if they're going to, like, block plus Lightning Strike, something that would help Soren resolve, but we could have just played it first. Hey, Redgrave.
Trust me. You'll thank me later. Let's take it back.
So they can use the explosion if they would like to kill the Teferi. That also just gets the explosion out of their hand, make it only cycle. If they drew a land here, though, they get to, you know, divination. Explosion.
You just let me know if you're up for round two.
We have Disparks in here too. Hey, called it. Somebody asked why not Dispark instead of Contempt. And we had those too. That worked. And thanks Zaw for the Dispark luck there. Okay. Got there. 3-1. I don't know of like what are the best decks in the new format yet. I mean it's pretty early. All four of the other decks that we're playing after this I like quite a bit. Those are four decks that I made that we played earlier, like the last couple of days, that thought all of them felt pretty strong. And so yeah, just kind of grab your popcorn and sit back, and we're gonna be playing ranked matches in Mythic with these four decks after this and try them out some more. It's going great, Zerif. Yeah, going great. We've had a bad case of mulliganing a lot with this deck. Been playing against... What decks have I been playing against the most? Been playing against a lot of Grixis. And a lot of... A lot of mono-white, too. I have not seen Endgame. I'm planning on doing that on Tuesday. So I'm going to change the stream time on Tuesday. Instead of 3 to 10, like always, I'm going to just bump it up 3 hours and go noon to 7 and then go see the movie after that. It's neither. I wouldn't say the Gruul deck is Gruul Warriors or Gruul Stompy. The first couple days we didn't play against, like, especially Thursday, we didn't play against, like, hardly any Esper. I've seen more Esper like yesterday than before. So basically, is this Esper control or is this like blue-black with... I mean, if this is Esper control, I want to cast Hostage Shaker here and... tuck my hero precinct one. Bleh. Should've just done that. I wish that was a May. I don't even want to get rid of that. But there's just a decent chance that they have like Nicol Bolas here again, or another campaign, something that just makes me discard. So yeah, that Deputy Detention was horrible. That card's coming out here. We can't really afford to draw those kind of cards whenever we're on 5 cards. Yeah, I think Sultai's still strong. Yeah, we still got this. We just need to draw a Teferi or a Liliana here. Basically taking four to make them skip their turn. Stop drawing Deputy of Detention. They have this Nicol Bolas line messed up.
Let us march into battle and make new comrades.
So, of course, the Dragon God gets the minus and kill Liliana, unfortunately. I think Bolas is supposed to yell no like that whenever he dies, not like whenever the other person exiles a card from their hand.
Death won't conquer me so easily.
I have other schemes to attend. You have no weakness I cannot exploit.
I require servants. Your corpse will volunteer.
No, because the card exiled isn't good enough. That could be it. Alright, sideboard in a bunch of stuff. Take out a bunch of other stuff. Yeah, that looks good. All right, I'm going to keep my seven this time. Basically, all of our losses are mold of fives and mold of fours. I'm just going to keep my seven, no matter what it is. Seven cards, I'm keeping it. They're going to make me discard a bunch of cards anyway, so even if we have crappy hand, doesn't matter. It's better just to have the seven cards than have five. Can't really compete with five against disinformation campaign. Seven lands is definitely a keep. I'd rather have seven lands than seven spells. I'll take seven lands all day, though, because then they'll just blanks their Thought Erasures and Duresses and just play off the top. All right, so what do we get to keep? Well, we're actually keeping a good hand. Yeah, you can't mold a four if you just keep seven. Yeah, the deck command only works like every 30 seconds or so. So whenever somebody does it, gotta wait a little while before you do it again. Brown. kind of wanted just to keep up Dovin's Veto, thinking that they would probably have a Thought Erasure or Escanta on turn two, and just be able to Dovin's Veto it immediately, and then Slam Thief. But this is okay, we're going to wait. I'm just going to play my land pass. Veto the campaign. And then, I guess, play Thief. Well, that is true. They don't have any untapped lands, do they? I guess I should just Slam Thief right now. Oh, that's a Blood Crypt. I'll still just Slam Thief right now. Let's have them bedevil this. And then I'd like to draw a black source and just go Bell Haunt. Then campaign's annoying. Hey, Magic Harry. Welcome to the channel. Alright, so I play Bell Haunt, they play Campaign, I discard Glacial Fortress. Then I'm trying to have Thief plus Dovin's Veto the next turn. Second sub of the day. I know how good that card is. I want that out of there. Not sure how we're gonna get in with this other thief yet. But we'll see. And Denriel as well with the Twitch Prime sub. Getting some more hype boats in the chat. If you're a subscriber, don't forget to get your hype boats out there for our two new ones. Thank you, Denriel. Enjoy all the awesome
boats. Make the multiverse in my image.
Bolas is so good.
I am Death's master.
Perfect. Great draw step. Perfect. So would we want to hit them? So this is a tough call. They make me... I have to exile something. Mortify is the easy thing, but then if they drew a creature, then I'm going to wish I had that Mortify. I guess I'm going to get rid of one of the lands. It's kind of tough, though. Lands are just so necessary with Thief of Sanity.
Let your weak minds crumble.
So do we go super greed mode and hit them with Thief, or do we hit Bolas? I think we just hit Bolas.
Another time, Planeswalker.
Warrior Queen Necromancer has a nice ring to it. Let's reduce the battle to shambles.
Ugh. Yeah, that would have been the best line. It is hit a new Bolas. off of the thief. Yeah, we could have gone really greedy and attacked them and try to find some removal spell for Bolas for sure, but
rise.
Okay, a Liliana battle. Ours has more loyalty.
If I were you, I'd rise and shine. Putrid, but effective.
Hey, Intellivine, what's up?
So that's how it is.
So it's better for us to not have the two creatures draw on their turn, because, you know, if we both draw, then I'm getting a card in my hand that's good against their discard spells. Because that's a bad time for me to each draw a card, because it lets them use the mana first. And then plus if they have like a Thought Erasure in hand, then I would have just been drawing a card for their Thought Erasure.
Death is enlightening. Waste not, want not.
After this league, whenever we either lose our second match or win five. So if we're down a game here, so if we lose this game, then we'll be going to Grixis Control
like
after this.
This looks like a fun new toy.
I have not made any Tezzeret decks yet, no.
Smelly, but effective.
Please no discard. Just play some other spell that gets counter. And to waste it on a Dovin's Veto on a Thought Erasure. Yeah, I think they likely had that Thought Erasure last turn. Hey, what's up, Hero? And Friel. If I do this, they draw. If I block here, we both draw.
They were a lousy servant anyway. For you later.
So it looks like they'd rather me keep my 2/2 creature than draw a card.
Good help is easy to find in war.
Which, that's fine. Yeah, there's a... That said somewhere how much rank you lose at the start of a new season. I don't know where it is. That certainly said somewhere.
I've learned much from your death.
I made a blue-black self-mill that has an idea but needs to be refined. I'll send you a list for you to work on if you think it has potential. Okay, cool.
What a good, mindless minion.
That's why we'd rather be drawn on our turn than their turn. Why didn't trade earlier?
You're both dead. Waste not, want not.
Eldritch Reborn is awesome. It's gonna be really hard for them to answer Eldritch Reborn, and we get to grab Nicol Bolas back again. Our opponent's not playing Syncopate, but yeah, I guess I didn't play around Syncopate. Sure.
Make this quick. I'm bored already.
Ooh, sorry.
Not really.
Discarding Ritual of Sit.
Unrefined.
They were a lousy servant anyway.
Just gotta get Nicol Bolas out of here.
Get out of my way!
I'll find a use for you later.
And keeping the swamp in hand to either discard with Davriel or if there's another campaign or something like that. This one looked really bad for us earlier. Our opponent having a Liliana and neither of us having either any cards, but then we top deck our own Liliana. And, you know, been drawing a little better since then.
I've learned much from your death.
This is one or fewer cards, so I can cast this to Spark here, and I'll still have two cards. Vaffle with the Twitch Prime sub. Welcome, Vaffle.
The whole of the multiverse will bend to my will. All the cosmos are mine to control.
That card was pretty good. Oh, I didn't even notice I drew a Thought Erasure. I guess I didn't need to do that. I honestly didn't even notice I drew a Thought Erasure. I was doing some stuff over there. Well, so basically I thought they had a good card in hand because they discarded the Ritual of Soot. So I thought they had a pretty good card.
Empty your mind.
Is their life total at 20? Wonder if I should just keep making 2/2s.
Smelly, but effective.
I am all there is to know.
Yeah, Nicol Bolas' abilities are too overwhelming. I agree.
Rise and shine.
Everything is power, and I am.
They like need a Ritual of Soot. And then if they draw a Ritual of Soot, we get to draw 5 cards because of Dreadhorde General. Yeah, it's like a delayed draw, because, you know, like, they have to kill the 2-2, and then we'll still draw the card with the 2-2. But we also just put a lot faster clock on them to end this game with us having this advantage.
I am exhausted.
I will return. Witness a mote of my power.
Alright, we'll just cast this. Now they have to draw Ritual of Set. Do they draw it or no? Yeah, that was, yeah, that is pretty similar to the spirits that Ugin makes. It's true. Yeah, Cry of the Carnarium would be a lot better than Soot. But we've seen them have Soot both games. We haven't seen Cry of the Carnarium. Ugh. All right, game three. Tough game three here. Our opponent's contemplating their sideboard plan. They need a re-sideboard. Zeitgeist, welcome back. Fifth sub of the day. Keeping the hype boats going. Thanks, Zeitgeist. What do you think of the new mulligan rule for Modern? Did it break the format in this Mythic Championship or not? Honestly, I haven't been watching the Mythic Championship. You know, I've been streaming all weekend and everything, and I don't know if it. I like the mulligan rule just in general. Now, for specifically for Modern, I'm not sure. I don't know if it breaks the format. Probably not. I haven't really seen anybody like complain about it too much or anything, so. Oh, thanks, Zeitgeist. Hey, Shane, my day's going really good. Yeah, we're going to be doing a lot of ranked matches today with the thing resetting in 2 days. We'll see how far we can go up. We just got to Mythic not too long ago because we started. So last week, so basically almost 2 weeks ago is whenever we started playing ranked matches, and we got to Mythic on Thursday. Yeah, we definitely had definitely have had surprises from the new set both ways. These are all tap lands. A few cards that I've been surprised at how good they are. Tamio, Vivian. Sorin. Those are all better than I thought they would be. Narset's been worse than I thought she would be. Ooh, Nicol Bolas Dragon God bites the dust. So would I rather Eldest Reborn and get that going, or Teferi tuck this thing? I think I'd rather get Eldest Reborn going. Tamiyo is really good in the Wilderness Reclamation deck. In just Simic Nexus.
This isn't a fight. You need to slow down.
All right, so now our Eldest Reborn will go grab Nicol Bolas Dragon God next turn. And I think they're dead. Looks like we got this one. My name is Hunter. Welcome.
We need to move quickly.
Sub number 6 on the day. Thanks for that Twitch Prime sub. Where is the hype boats? There they are. Yeah, I took the wrong card. I forgot about them getting rid of a card. Yeah, I took the wrong card because they have to. I mean, it doesn't matter. We have the Dovin's Veto. It just doesn't matter. But I should have taken the Contempt. I forgot about how we were gonna get rid of one of their permanents also.
I will return one day. My schemes are never ending.
Boom. Victory. All right. 4-1. That one looked pretty bad for us earlier. But we ended up getting there. All right, so we are at the final boss. Either we win and we get our 5 win, or we lose and we are done. So since this is the final boss, we got our own final boss playlist. And get your final boss emotes in the chat. Gotta get our head right. Try to pick this one up. That game was a whole lot easier because of our opponent having 3 tap lands, really. Yeah, if they just didn't have the tap lands, their hand would have been amazing. Well, at least we're not mulliganing to 5. Did you send that to me last night with the... We had a Chrono Trigger theme that was sent to me last night. I hadn't checked it out yet. Is that the one you're talking about, Crambler? Is there a deck you can recommend for a player who has returned after 10 years and is in this new expansion? I think you probably want a very proactive deck if you're just returning to Standard here, haven't played much Standard recently. You want something just proactive where you're trying to do your own game plan and you don't really care what your opponent's game plan is too much. Taking Swift Blade so that even if the Hostage Taker dies, the Swift Blade will at least be reset. Oh, gotcha, Scrambler. Is it on Spotify? It does need to be on Spotify. Oh man, that's an awesome card. Can we survive? I don't like that they shocked in here. That's scary. No, giant growth. Nope, we're dead. And we're just taking lethal. Okay, so they have Colossus also. All right, some sideboard cards. So do I want things like Duress and Dovin's Veto against like this deck that's going to be full of pump spells? Going no. I don't think the Spark does a whole lot. Didn't do anything against any creature they have. Yeah, I'm guessing we're gonna have to cut Thief of Sandy as well. It's just too slow. And if we're cutting Thief, then we're probably cutting Sorin. I think those are our two cards that are coming out here. If they have a feather, Dovin's Veto doesn't counter stuff, but they played a lot of creatures that were not feather. I assume they have feather, though, as well. That's too bad, Crambler. Yeah, it's tough to find some of those themes on Spotify. Yeah, Time Wipe works well with our creatures. It works well with Hostage Taker, Bell Hunt, things like that, of picking these cards up, especially Deputy Detention as well. Picking up Deputy Detention. I mean, this hand's great, except for we just don't have land, so guess we're mulliganing. If that was a black source for Bell Haunt, I would consider it, but let's just get rid of it. We're probably going to need some more spells. Yeah, these sleeves were just for the War of the Spark pre-order. You had to pre-order, which it's you cannot anymore. But you had to pre-order the 50-pack bundle of War of the Spark to get those sleeves. No, we don't necessarily win this yet. We can't cast anything in our hand besides Tyrant Scorn. I don't mind the lava coils on Bellhunt. You know, like, take a card, gain life, and, you know, take a lava coil. Like, I don't mind that. Lava coil on, like, deputy detention, that's definitely a lot worse for us. Need another black source. I could see them cycling the Defiant Strike here. And that's fine. Hooray, Black Source. Alright, here we go. Yeah, we're basically trying to clear these lava coils to protect Deputy Detention. But Divination's a good card. Or sorry, not Divination, sorry, Mind Rot. Mind Rot's a good card. That's what we're casting here. Mind Rot, gain 3 life. Luo! Welcome to the channel, Luo. Enjoy the 22 awesome emotes you get for subscribing. And that's sub number 7.
The undead make great minions. Loyal. Oh, this looks like a fun new toy.
Block. All right, we get to draw a card. They kept that card on top pretty quickly.
Death is enlightening.
Just taking that last card from their hand.
Rise.
Turn one kill deck in Modern. There's been turn one kill decks in Modern's past that, you know, require a whole lot of stuff. Someone was telling me about that it's like, I don't know exactly what it is, but it's like an Eldritch Evolution deck that doesn't necessarily require as many cards. Usually turn one kill decks, you know, have required like 7 cards, sometimes 8 cards. You know, that kind of stuff. I don't really know what it's all about, though. To be completely honest. The Lily quotes, I haven't been listening too hard to the Lily quotes. They seem pretty good, though. The spark doesn't get rid of anything. Siege Gang Commander Boar God. Yeah, that's pretty sweet. Put in a bunch of gobos and put the... I mean, just basically attacking with Boar God, though. Like, you're good. doesn't really matter what you're putting in. Basically, everything's good. I don't believe my opponent's playing any gods. We haven't seen any card above 4 CMC or greater yet. I'm gonna use the Mortify here so that, you know, I may need to, like, basically I want to just keep the cheaper card that can kind of help us double spell more. No, Ravager Worm's a lot better card than Siege Gang Commander. I wouldn't put in Siege Gang over anything in the Gruul deck. I don't think it's better than anything there, but it is a cute card you can play. I definitely want to play Liliana next turn. I'm kind of thinking this Hostage Shaker is going to die. But that's okay with drawing this Liliana. Or it's not going to die. Okay, yeah, if you're making a budget version, then yeah, go ahead. You know, budget version. Absolutely. I want my opponent to play the Vindicator here. Esper is coming. They did not play the Vindicator. Do they scry that land to the top? No, maybe they put it on the bottom. I thought they scryed to the top, but there's no way they would have just kept that land on top. That just wouldn't make sense. Yeah, it looks like we are going to be defeating the final boss. There we go. It's over. All right, Esper Hero. Had some tough mulligans. Those were basically the games we were losing was whenever we were mulliganing to 4, mulliganing to 5. Yeah, that was an awful matchup for our opponent, I think. Like, we just have so much removal and so many like 2-for-1s, like the Hostage Shakers, the Deputies. Like Liliana in that matchup also. Oh my gosh. Like, you're just trying to protect your creature or two and then just like, you know, come down, sacrifice 2 creatures. That's rude. So, yeah, the deck was pretty sweet. I still think we're missing Teferi. I think that the 3-mana Teferi, I think we're missing that card in the sideboard. I guess the card, I think Kaya can go. I think 3-mana Teferi is better than Kaya, and maybe one of the Contempts. I loved the Eldest Reborn over here. That card was awesome. Liliana, Dreadhorde General was amazing. It was a lot better than I thought it would be. You know, I was thinking that maybe we should just not have those because they cost 6 mana and have another Teferi, like have another 5-mana Teferi and like a, you know, an Oath of Kaya or a 3-mana Teferi or like, you know, something else. But this card was incredible. I was really, really pleasantly surprised how good this card was. Time Wipe also was really, really good. I was very pleasantly surprised at how good this card was. We cast a couple of time wipes where we'd pick up a deputy attention, give them their creature back. You know, like basically we'd have the deputy attention play it early, take their creature. They play more creatures out, and then we time wipe, pick up the deputy, give them the creature back, destroy them all, and then we'd have another deputy to play afterwards. That was awesome. Also, we curved Bell Hunt into time wipe another time, like where we just play the Bell Hunt, make them discard a card, gain 3 life, and then pick our card back up, our Bell Hunt back up, to be able to do that again the next turn. That was really impressive. So Liliana and time wipe both looked awesome. We basically never did anything with Sorin. We just never drew Sorin, didn't do anything with Sorin. I mean, we have 2 Lilianas, 2 Sorins, so it's like we could have been drawing a bunch of Sorins instead of a bunch of Lilianas, but never did anything with Sorin. But yeah, I'm not sure if we need like a total of 4 Bell Haunts against aggro, because maybe Othakaya is kind of the way to go. Like maybe just have like one or 2 Othakayas somewhere in like these 4 slots, and like another, or then just 3 mana Teferi for like reclamation decks, basically. That is true. We did technically win a game with Sorin, a game that we were going to be winning anyway. But yeah, when our opponent was at 1, we played a Sorin and did 1 damage. I think that's the only time we actually had a Sorin resolve. But yeah, Sorin bringing back Hero, Deputy, and Thief is awesome, and that's what I was excited to do. We just never really drew Sorin, so we never got to really do that. But I was excited to bring those things back with Sorin. But yeah, I think Sorin would be good if we would draw Sorin, basically. But yeah, this was, go back to our normal playlist. This deck was pretty sweet. All right, so there's Esper Hero. All right, so if you're watching this video later on YouTube, I hope you enjoyed it. For those of you in Twitch chat, if you don't know about the YouTube channel, right there, youtube.com/ToddStevensMTG. I have all the replays up there or afterwards. But thanks for watching some Esper Hero, and I will see you for